Hey guys, Rajiv here from Financial Hub India. So today's date is 29th of May 2018, and I'm recording a live Nifty trade here. We are short in Nifty right now on this flip layer of resistance here. This one. All right, and this becomes a resistance based on, you know, the support areas. We got this resistance over here. Since the trend was quite up in the 15-minute time frames, if you check out, we'll be seeing a good strength in the trend, which shifted the overall momentum right now below, with a fall below the key rope support right now. So this was the overall trend going on, and this was our last higher low in terms of a change of trend level. One of the idea we follow in the price action trades to define the shift of the overall price action structure. So when I go to the 5-minute time frames, you know, the first sign of reversal we got in here, if you see the break of the higher last higher highs, every time the higher high is broken, we got good amount of momentum here. But do you see the difference between this momentum up and this momentum up? Somehow this momentum is quite smooth, but here the break of the last higher highs are not much smooth. The price is not breaking out above the last higher high, isn't it? Which was the case in here. So a good sign of bullish momentum is when the last higher high in an uptrend, higher high, higher low momentum is broken and we are going smoothly towards upside. But that was a struggle the buyers were really having in these areas. So the first sign of reversal we got when the price rejected to go above the layer of last higher high after a major swing. So in this entire move, the major swing is this one basically, and then it moves up. Like the major swing happens in here, right? So after a major move or a major corrective swing, when the previous higher high is broken, we expect to see a big push towards upside above the last higher high, because you know there was sell off when the price was coming down and there was the fight going on. The bulls take the control from the bears, and then the bull is moving towards upside in a one-way momentum. And here, since the sellers are already sitting in, so the sellers should be taken away. And the buyers should be overcoming the sellers with a good momentum towards upside. So that's how a good trend should be moving. But that's not the scenario we have seen here. After this swing momentum, even though there was good amount of buying pressure over here, but buyers failed to move above this previous higher high. So I think this will be much clearer in a 5-minute time frame. If I show you here. You see this one, this was the last higher high. Okay, so and then price, after this pullback, price tries to move above this, but fails to do that, you know, creating a major resistance. And then we had a minor false break over here, price coming back down here. All right, so since we see that price is not able to sustain for more than two candles here, actually. You know, it's not even more two candles completely, because this 5-minute candle, most of it is outside this range. All right. So a strong false break, a strong rejection by the sellers. And then this sell-off we have been trying to capture, but we didn't get a chance to enter into this trade because there was no pullback as such. And the breakouts, to trade the breakouts, the key level comes around this layer, which is much, much lower. So we didn't get a chance in there. But in anyhow, till the time this support was not being broken, we were bullish in this. And we had a buy trade over here as well. You know, and we hit the stop loss over there in our buy trade of 1 hour. Right? And that was a buy, and that was quite a good trade for us because we had the bounces in here, you see. And we here also when we bought in around these two candles. So after the once we see the price reaching the layer of support here, the first sign of reversal was this shadow. You know, there was a deep there was a deep false break of this support, which is good enough. It means the sellers present in here were really trying hard to push the market down, but they eventually failed here with this push. And then after this push back up, we see the price is really holding the support here and then pushing up. So even though it was a good trade for us, it was a correct trade for us, but it didn't work out. And that's how the market is. There is no perfect setup or perfect trade for you. You'll have to trade the probabilities. All right. So even though the stop loss is set, we are very much satisfied in this trade because things were really good enough. Overall, our flattish structure was building up. So we have been targeting this layer of resistance here. And this was a bit tricky here to trade, but it was a bit easy here to trade because here we had a consolidation phase, you know, and then price breakout and a pullback and then a continuation kind of scenarios here. Price, this was a kill. I think there was a kill level around here, you know, so the price just opens up on that layer, goes up. There was a higher high buildup, and eventually there was a breakout formations and pullback. So there are a lot of things to go ahead with that trade. So in any way, even though we hit the stop loss, we have not we don't have much to lose, more than 1 hour. And if this trade would have worked out, then we would have made at least 6 hours in this trade. I mean, 1 hour versus plus 6 hours. So 6 times gain against 1 hour of loss. So anyhow, since this was a key layer of support, so we have been tracking the same layer of support for a breakdown trade as well. So this was a breakdown momentum here. And then price push back up, retest the same area of resistance here. So here about pullback, the breakout pullback strategy, we follow in the advanced course. You know, when there was a breakout and there was a pullback in a trend, then there were some entry strategies we follow. We are into those trade here, and already we are making here around more than 2 times of our risk in this trade, and we are targeting big in this trade basically. So let's see. What should be the target here? I see quite a big target basically, because we don't have much anything to worry much before we reach this layer of support, isn't it? Around here, do you see this? Around this layer of support. Yeah, we see the next layer. We see some buyers over there. The price is really holding that layer of support and resistance and breaks out, pull back to that layer and goes up. So in case we are able to make that in this trade, then hopefully you'll be making around 10 times 640, 550. Yeah, it'll be around, 8 to 10 times of the gain we'll be making 8 hours with a risk of 1 hour in this trade. So the strategy we did here is actually a lossier strategy, I'd say. I'll just show you my member section. So this is the trade, you know, this is the trade we have hit our stop loss, the one I have just discussed with you guys. And this is the one we've been tracking. I'll just zoom it up. This was a simple trade, you know, support areas. We've been tracking this during the workout. Then the same level will be going short with our pullback trading strategy. So that's what I've been doing with my members here. Yeah, so let's see how it works out, whether we are able to make 10 hours or no. And definitely we'll be training our stop loss on its way down till the time it reaches the target. In case you are not in the free channel today, I didn't really get time to post any charts in the free channel. So in case you are not in the free channel, please be in there. Please be in there. At least you'll be getting the updates also, the video updates and all. All right, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.